Hey, it's Sly Gittens here. Today, we're diving into Microsoft Self-Service Password Reset. It's a game changer in managing your credentials securely and efficiently. In this tutorial, you're going to learn how to enable self-service password reset for a group of Microsoft Entra users, set up authentication methods and registration options. Let's get started and see how it can transform your password management. How do we get to do self-service password reset? The way I like to go is go to admin.microsoft.com, proceed to the left-hand side, go to identity, then you're going to be entra.microsoft.com, and then when we get here, we go protection, then we go to password reset. You also can just go straight to entra.microsoft.com, and then go to protection and password reset, and you'll be able to get to the self-service password reset. When we get here, we're going to see properties. Click on that. You have the ability to create a group and create a group of users and select that group and self-service password reset. You can also do all of them. So everyone can do it in the organization. You can actually do, no one has the ability to self-service password reset. And why would you want that? In some environments where security is at the highest, you might not want someone to be able to do their own self-service reset because of security vulnerabilities. So maybe a bad actor is trying to reset that password. A lot of companies leverage this because it takes off the burden off the IT team to have to do this, and you still can make it secure when you're applying this. So for right now, we're just going to keep that selected. We're going to use this user group. That's what we're going to apply it to. The next thing let's take a look at now is the authentication methods. Authentication methods for self-service password reset. Now can be managed right here. You can say, let's do two of these requirements could be met. You can use one. Let's say two. You can say email and phone number. I like to do app notification and also app code. You can have that as well. Some people use office phone. That's not one that I see too often. You do see that sometimes. You can also use the old school security questions. You can leverage that as well. But email, mobile, that's the one I usually see. I also like to throw the app code in there or the app notification as well to give my users some flexibility. Then we could take a look at when a user logins. Let's require, let's do this. The number of days before a user asks to reconfirm their authentication information. In my environment, I use 180. You can use what you like. I see some people use 90. I see some people don't use this at all. You can leverage that as well. What notifications do you want to use? Do you want to be notified when users on password resets, right? Notify all admins when other admins reset their password. You can do that depending on the security posture in your organization is what you want to leverage in when you're selecting these. You can also customize, if you have a customized help desk link, you can create that and point it here, right in here as well. And also, if I had an on-premise instance of Active Directory, I can leverage this to integrate password reset with that on-premise environment. And then you can add in here the different administrator policies. But we just took a look at quickly adding password reset. Again, it's great for organizations who want to take some of that workload off of those administrators. My name is Sly Gittens. Thanks for tuning in.